and welcome. Thank you for joining me today. My name is Ruby and I'll be leading you through a beginner-friendly yin yoga practice. Before we get started, you will need a yoga mat, your yoga strap, a yoga block, a pillow, and possibly a rolled up yoga mat. As we move through the practice, I will do my best to use my words to help you move from pose to pose. When it is time to release from a pose and move to the next pose, you will hear this sound. We will hold each pose for 3 to 4 minutes. I will not talk during the pose. Again, when you hear that sound, that's when you'll know it is time to release from the pose. My goal for you for this practice is to completely zen out, completely relax, and to tune out from the world and tune into yourself, if even for just this next 45 minutes to an hour that we spend together. So let's get started. We're gonna begin today in child's pose. Knees wide to the edges of your mat, toes close together, arms out long. Ideally, you want your forehead to come to the mat. If your forehead does not meet the mat, you can take a block and place it underneath of your forehead. You do wanna make sure that your elbows are relaxed and the space between your shoulders is open, okay? Take all the time that you need setting up. Once you get into the pose, take 10 long, easy breaths in through your nose and out of your mouth. And again, I'll let you know when it's time to release from your pose. Enjoy. to the palms of your hands. Bring your knees in a little bit closer as you come into your tabletop position. 10 cat cows. Cat, hands and feet press. Pull your belly into your spine, chin into your chest, round your tailbone. Cow, tuck your toes, lower your belly, lift your tail, lift your gaze, open your heart. 9 more. Flat back, full breath in, open mouth exhale. Sit down onto your mat. Send your legs out long first. Release the flesh from your sit bones. Send your left leg as far to the left side as you can get it without overworking. Bend your right knee half butterfly. You'll bring the sole of your right foot to the inside of your left leg. Your hands will just rest on the ground in front of you. You may or may not need a block for this forward fold. Walk your hands out, hinging at your waist as you fold over your bent right leg. Breathe depth into your posture. Let your forehead rest either on a block, or if you can make your head to the ground, your invitation is open. 10 deep breaths when you arrive. walking your hands back, lifting into your seat. Keep your half butterfly legs. Use your strap around the underneath of the ankle, your left ankle. Keeping the strap at your ankle, just take your strap in your left hand, both sides of the strap. You may want to use your pillow here as well. Place the pillow over the left leg, close to the left side body. Let the arm rest on the pillow with the strap. Right arm up. Leaning towards the left foot with the right arm. Do not fold forward, sinking in. Stay lifted. If your right hand does not connect to your left foot, first of all, know that you're not alone. Second of all, use your left hand to bring the strap into your right hand. You want to try to keep your right arm straight so that you're feeling a stretch all the way down the right side of your body. Let your left arm relax. If your head is sinking, use a block on the shortest height. Place it in between your left shoulder and like the back of your head. Make sure it's not pressing into your left ear. It should be right against your skull. Take that strap back into the right hand. Your stretch here should be on the outside of your left, right hip, right side body. Ten deep breaths. You should never feel pain. If you feel pain, come out of the pose or release a little bit. Release the right arm down. Man, that is an intense stretch. Come on back to center. So take anything out of the way that might be in your way. Just sit with your legs out, arms resting, eyes closed for a few breaths. Observing any sensations as they arise without the need to change or alter. Now take your right leg, extend it long to the right side of your mat. Left foot, inner right thigh, half butterfly. A block if it's needed. Hands on the ground, walking forward as you hinge through your waist to fold. Keeping your right foot dorsiflexed. 10 deep breath cycles. Lifting back up to your seat, keeping your legs exactly how they are. Inviting the strap now underneath of your right ankle. Taking hold of it with your right hand. You can choose to use the pillow like you did on the left side, or if you would like to try it without, or you didn't need it, don't use it here. Right, left arm up, big stretch, leaning to your right. Keeping the left arm reaching towards the right foot. Option to use the strap as an extender. Starting the pose with 10 very deep breaths in and out. Take your time as you come out of your posture. Both of your feet will meet now. I will encourage you to lengthen your legs. So instead of butterfly legs, finding more of a diamond shape with your legs. Be sure that there's no flesh underneath of the sits bones so that you can root firmly into the ground. You may or may not need your block. I know I need it, so I'm gonna put it right here. Taking a few breaths, recuperating from your last pose. Shoulders over your hips. 5 breath cycles. Open the eyes if you close them. Both arms inhale overhead, maybe even taking your gaze with you. As you exhale, fold forward. Remember, when you fold, it's lengthening of your spine, hinging at your waist. Hands connect to the ground either in front of you, possibly next to you, depending on the depth of your fold. You can interlock your fingers, wrap around the edges of your feet. Make sure that your elbows are resting, whether outside of your shins or knees. And then allow your forehead to come down to rest. If your forehead can meet your feet, beautiful. Again, you may need a block. Remember that your block has 3 different heights. Once you are settled, you should be feeling a stretch through your low back and possibly your glutes. Invite 10 breath cycles into and out of the body.
Slowly lift up and away from your forward fold. Bring your knees together and extend your legs long. Take your time getting there. Pedal out your feet and roll through your ankles. Be sure to remove any flesh from your sit bones so that you're rooted on the ground. Grab your rolled up yoga mat. Lift the knees very gently and place the yoga mat underneath of your knees. If you need more lift, you can use a yoga block on the second height. You'll place it underneath of the knees. Decide which prop you would like to use. If you don't want any props at all, that's okay too. We'll lift both arms overhead. Pull your toes in towards your knees. Lift even taller. As you breathe out, fold your body forward, hinging at the waist, as if you're sitting your chest on your thighs. Hands will rest on the ground, or if your hands connect to the edges of your feet, you can make that connection. Continue to look forward for a few breaths. Long inhales, grow through your spine. Deep exhales, find depth in your posture. Continue to breathe. Option to take a block on your shins and rest your forehead on your block. Take 10 deep breaths in through your nose and out of your mouth.
like a caterpillar. Slowly roll yourself all the way up. Nice and slow as you lift.
Stack your shoulders over your hips and just relax for a moment in your seated position. Come to tabletop position. Once you find tabletop, bring your left hand closer to your right hand. Then bring your left foot outside of both hands, keeping your right knee and the top of your right foot resting on the ground. You're either going to keep both of your hands on the ground with your arms long, or you can bring more depth into the posture by bringing your elbows and your forearms down to the earth. Maybe you need the earth to come up to you just a little bit. You can use your block. Place your block down. Rest your forearms on the block. You can take it a little bit deeper by pulling onto the left pinky edge side of your left foot, placing your left hand to the inside of the left knee crease. Whether your right forearm is on the ground or a block, I would suggest bringing it parallel to the front edge of your mat for extra space. Gazing over your left shoulder, letting go of any muscle engagement that you don't need for this posture. Focus in with 10 breath cycles. Palms of your hands to the mat. If the hip is open, pull your left knee into center. From here, just shift your hips back until they are stacked over your right knee. Walk the hands back just a little bit if that is needed. Bring your left knee to meet your right knee. Three cat cows. Take your knees wide, bring your toes together, sit back into a child's pose, flip your palms up,
Forehead rest, 5 breaths. Lift to table and move to the next side. Right hand closer to the left hand. Right foot outside of your hands. Lizard pose. Now we are going to be here for a little while, so maybe you start lifted and work your way deeper into the pose as your body allows it. Focus in with 10 deep breaths, first in through your nose and out of your mouth.
And then we'll let you know when it is time to release from lizard.
Focus inward, breathe. Connect your palms to the earth. Push yourself up. Take the time you need, releasing out of your pose. Shift the hips back until they stack over your left knee. Walk the hands back. Bring your right knee to meet your left knee, tabletop first. 3 mindful cat-cows.
After your third cat-cow, sink into child's pose, flip your palms, and again, rest for 5 breaths. Back up from child's to table. Swing your legs around, come to sit back down onto your mat. Make sure that you're about the midline of your mat as you sit down. And slowly make your way onto the back side of your body. Make sure your low back is connected to the earth. If you need to lift your knees into your chest, give yourself a moment to do so. Find stillness on your back. Footprints to the sky, happy baby. Sink your knees to your side bodies. Invitation to remain still. 10 long, easy breaths. Release your hands from your feet. Let your feet connect to the ground. Hands resting on your belly. Windshield wiper your knees slowly from left to right. A few more breaths of movement. Windshield wiping your knees slowly left to right. Return to center, one full breath. Extend your legs long to the end of your mat. Inhale, both arms overhead. Rest. Extend your arms again. And then pull both of your arms to the left side. You want to be sure when you come back to rest that your shoulders and your elbows are resting on the ground. Left foot outside of your mat. Your right ankle will wrap over your left ankle, and you'll use your left toes to keep your right foot locked. And banana pose. Your gaze is just gently lifted, no twisting and no straining of your neck. Long inhale, long easy exhale. We're gonna be chilling here for just a little while longer. Normal breath. Slowly make your way back to center. Long stretch, point your toes, pull your fingers. Relax on your exhale. Extend both arms, pull them to the right. You might have to lift your head and shoulders just a bit, but be sure to bring them back down to the ground. Right leg outside of the mat. Your left ankle wraps around your right, locking your right foot, left foot with your right toes. Long inhalation through your nostrils. Open mouth, exhale.
normal breathing for just a few moments. Returning to center, extending once more and lengthening your legs and your arms, full breath in and out. Five-point star, separate the feet a little bit outside of mat width apart. Same with the arms and the hands. Relax. Just let your body sink further into the ground with every exhale.
Let your arms straight down by your body. Your legs can stay how they are, or maybe you choose to bring them in closer together. Final rest, Savasana. Do what you need to get yourself completely relaxed and rested. Once your body is still, inhale through both nostrils. Exhale out of your mouth. One more breath in through your nose and out of your mouth. Let go. Release. Enjoy. Your body organically. Bring both feet to touch the ground. Move your legs. Move your arms. Make your way over to your right side. Stay in your fetal position for at least a few breaths.
push up to your seat.
Find one ankle in front of the other. Sweep your arms overhead, let your palms meet. Hands to heart center. Invitation to bow your forehead and close your eyes. Thank you for joining me in Yin Yoga. I pray that you always stay on your inward journey. And until we meet again,
Namaste.